predictable. As you can see, there is TC upkeep right there. You can see all the bunker by the ship at the top. Jumping into the gatehouse, we have a box that you can stand on and kill enemies in the combat. Breaking the furnace in the wall, you can shoot raiders who try to breach the compound. Jumping into the compound, we have a turret blocking anybody that tries to get in, and a little funnel wall, so raiders have a tough time getting in. As you can see, there's a bedroom to the right, and jumping into the interior, we have a little breach to kill any raiders trying to break into the main doors. Going inside, we have a little starting area for tier 2, locker, furnace, and drop boxes. Going into the main core where our TC will be, you can place a roof bunker right there and upgrade it to any material that you like. If you break the wood, the roof will disappear due to its stability. You can just place a staircase right there to get up during the day. And there's main TC upkeep right there. Take a nice little furnace jump up to the open core. You have plenty of boxes for your entire wipe, tier 3, and an extra locker just in case. You also have a ramp with a turret guarding the entire open core. Heading up to your bedroom floor, you have two bedrooms for your new teammate, and also the ramp Pico was talking about before. Headed through the single door, we have our shooting floor, where you can shoot enemies below in your compound, and enemies far using this ramp. As you can see, I placed ramps right here just for better angles on the enemies. Heading to the roof, we have two garage doors, plus a large space to place a mini copter and two turrets. And let's jump into the build. Alright, for your starter, you want to make sure you have enough room to make a raised triangle foundation for the bunker. It's just a simple little base. You're gonna place doors here just to make sure you don't get beat on. And this is how my space looks. And then for the TC area, this is what I went with. Just classic. And you also wanna make sure that that foundation is one so you can chop it out later for the bunker. And then we're gonna move on to the honeycomb once you have enough resources for it. And that's all around the base. Now we're gonna add our jumper. Now you want to wall in your entire second floor except for one slot for a doorway. Here you can use a twig jump up or a ladder as a jump up. Whatever you have. And then you can change up the second floor however you like, but this is just how I like to do it. Make sure you keep the wall how I put it, and don't rotate it like I did. I don't know why I did that there. You can place a siren light for better mobility around the base. Dropping back down into the core, you can replace all those sheet doors with garage doors once you get to tier 2. Now you want to replace your starting area with a loot room. You can go ahead and upgrade your entire core to sheet and the floor above it armor. This is how your base should be looking by now. Now replace all the doors on the second floor with garage doors. The reason why you can't place this ramp is because of the boxes right above the jump up. Thank you. then, once you have the resources, upgrade your entire base to metal. Now come to one of the three corners on the base, and we're going to do the external TC. If you think you got it, place a triangle and remove the first square, and if it stays on the building, then you got it. Now repeat this on all three sides of the base. Upgrade this honeycomb to metal whenever you can. I just did it in stone for the video. I'm not sure why. Thank you. Now repeat this on all three of the sides. The triangles will only be on this side because this is where the turret pod is, and I'll show you what it looks like on the other side. This is what it looks like on the other side. Okay, right here you have two options. One is to place a window, and the other is to place a low wall. And I went with the window, just for a better peek on the roof. Now let's move on to the compound bedrooms. Now, just do that again on the other three sides of the base. Now we're gonna do the compound. Place the large furnace as high as you can, and as soon as you got it high enough, step back. just do this on the other sides. You can do your barricades however you want, but it's just how I do it. Now you want to place your compound wall in between the wood and the stone part. But don't place it too close to the large furnace because it'll stop you from placing the second wall. Now just do this again on the other sides. Now we're gonna do the entrance to our roof. You can place the roof on top of the window either in or out. It doesn't matter to me. And then for your turbines, I do two in the exact same spot, but you can place yours if you need more, wherever you want. And that's the video. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next one.